I'm gonna be talking to myself, don't judge me. Okay. So, what you need to make this. The t-shirt you never wear in the back of your closet. The hair ties you never use because they got metal on them. Scissors, measuring tape, pens if you have them, a sewing machine if you have it, you can also do it by hand, and a seam ripper if you have a sewing machine because you'll probably make a mistake. Oh, and a pen. I think that's all you need. Okay, so, you're gonna start by laying out your t-shirt. You can iron it, probably be a lot easier. I didn't, but here we are. Measuring tape and measuring stick. I see a lot of people are doing a 6x9 rectangle. I did that for my first one. I ended up having to put pleats in the top because it was just a little too long up top for me. For this one that I'm doing, I'm going to do a 9x8 on the top and then a 6 on the short side. So you start by measuring that out, marking it with your pen. I try to do it in the corner so I can make as many masks as I can of the shirt. And then you cut it out with your scissors. And you get 2 sheets with, this is the 8x9x6. You need 2 layers. You need your hair ties. Started by, you just cut off the little metal pieces that are on here. You're gonna need 3 of those. And we're gonna start sewing. Machine is shredded, we got our 2 pieces and our 3 hair ties. Turn that on. You're gonna start and set your hair ties aside. You're gonna start by sewing a 3/8 all the way around, except you wanna leave a gap up here, so I'm gonna mark my pen. Just like, not yay big, but I don't know, 1.5 inches, 2 inches. You'll see why later. So you just don't want to sew between those two. So I'm going to start by starting at this right here. We're going to put that mark right underneath my needle. And it obviously does not have to be a perfect size inch. I'm just going to sew that. I'm going to leave my needle in. Pick that up. Turn it. Okay. Be nice and flat. Put my foot back down. So here, I'm gonna take 1 of your hair ties, and I'm actually gonna sew a little bit down from the corner. Smidge. Okay, I'm gonna make sure my needle is in my fabric and pick up my foot. Gonna kind of open this. Try to be careful not to move it too much. I'm gonna stick my hair tie right on in here. You guys see it with my hand out there. I'm gonna stick it in. And kind of under my foot, like right in front of my needle, just one end. And you're putting it in between the fabric. And I'm gonna fold this back over so it's nice and flat. And I'm gonna put this down on the elastic if my needle will let me. You really gotta shove it in there. And if you're skilled enough, just leave your foot up and sew it because it's a bit of a struggle. Okay? So that's in there. And I'm gonna sew right over the top of it. It's in. I'm gonna continue on sewing right down to the bottom. Get about here. Make sure my hair tie's not getting in it quite yet. I'm gonna get pretty far from the bottom. Right about here. I'm gonna do the same thing. Lift my foot up. Take that other end of the hair tie that's in here and pull it in front of my foot or my needle. Shove it under the foot. Yep, just like that. Put that back down. And put my foot back down. And sew right over the top of it. Okay, into the corner, needle in. Pick my foot back up. Pick that around. Put my foot back down. And go all the way across the bottom. Into the corner, needle down. Foot up. Turn it again. Foot back down, sew a little bit out of the corner. And you wanna make it kinda as even as you can. So I'm about that far in. I'm gonna go like one more stitch. Put the needle down, bring this up. Another hair tie. Open up your layers here, and you're gonna shove one end right underneath your foot. Kind of sew over that. this back down. And we'll go right along with this. This one is a little right about there. Put my needle down, pick this up, take the other end, shove it right on under there. Put that back down, put this back down. So on the top of that, right on into the corner. Needle down, foot up, turn to the last time. Needle down, or foot down. And I'm gonna sew to that other mark on the other side, right here. Pull that up, foot up, and you can take it out of your machine. So you should have that. Hair tie is on the inside, and sewed all around except for in between your two little spaces there. Grab your scissors, and cut off any of your little ends here. Now you're here, you're going to go to your little spot that you didn't sew, and you're gonna turn your mask inside out. So you're gonna kinda carefully pull it through there if you didn't double stitch, but it's not that big of a deal, just stitch over it. And kinda pull it through that hole and inside it out. Alright, you should have that now. Now would be a good time to iron if you want to. Definitely don't have to, cause I'm not going to. So now from here, you're gonna take this little top part here, and you're gonna put it on your face now and decide which side you want to be towards you and which side you want to be out. Sometimes like the fabric fits a little different. Now you're gonna take your measuring tape and you're gonna measure where the center is on the top part where your opening is. I'm gonna take my pen and I'm gonna mark middle. And I'm gonna do this on the side that's gonna go towards me just because I think it'll look nicer, but obviously it doesn't matter that much. Alright, so now you're gonna measure 2 inches on either side of that mark here. And then do about a half an inch down from the top. So about there, about there. And then you're gonna kind of draw a box. Doesn't have to be crazy accurate. This is just for your like nose support. You're gonna sew your box sticker under here. Foot down. And sew that line. And cut off these pieces again. Now you're gonna do your pleats. So pleats are kind of up to you. You can do 3 small ones, 2 big ones, 1 really big one. I kind of put it on my face and determine where I'm gonna put them to make it fit my face better. And probably one like here. Flip it up like this so you can kind of see like right here. Right here is where I'd like to make them. I'm actually gonna pin it a little further in away from the edge so I don't actually have to take the pin out when I go to sew it. And they're pretty tiny pleats. They're not too big. 3/4 of an inch. Back to the sewing machine. And you're gonna sew it. Hold that right in front of the foot. Put my foot down. Sew right on through it. And I'm actually gonna back up through it too. And then you can cut all these off. Okay. Last step, take your final hair tie, and with your little box that you made at the top here, you're gonna take one end of it, and the other, and you cut it to length, so it should be about 4 inches. And you're gonna put it, you gonna feed it on into there, so stick one end in. Bring it all the way to the end, and then you're gonna stick the other end in. Just like that. You're gonna stick it back on your needle, and you're just gonna sew that edge together. Just like that. And you cut off the final strings. And done. You are done. You got a whole mess. I'm going away. Keep on going.